The next speaker is Azerbaijan. It will be followed by Kenya, which closes the list of speakers. Azerbaijan, you have the floor. We cannot hear you.
Thank you, Mr. High Commissioner. Excellences, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I would like to also, on behalf of the delegation of the Republic of Azerbaijan, extend sincere congratulations for the endorsement, successful endorsement of Global Compact on Refugees. And Mr. High Commissioner, I would like also to extend sincere appreciation and thanks for inviting us to this event, which is of particular importance for Azerbaijan as a country which hosts in per capita terms one of the highest cases of refugees and IDPs in the world. And this year is particularly actual and crucial, and just in recognition of that, I also would like to underline that last year, in May 2017, we also hosted in Baku a fourth World Forum on intercultural dialogue, and one of the thematic sessions was devoted to welcoming culture towards migrants and refugees and role of municipal authorities. As I mentioned, Azerbaijan hosts in per capita terms one of the highest caselots of refugees and IDPs, and over the last 25 years accumulated an extensive knowledge base and experience in dealing with large-scale displacement. And Azerbaijan, as a full-fledged member of the Executive Committee of UNHCR and member of United Nations, deeply recognizing its responsibility, honors its obligation and commitments, both in line with UN conventions on refugees and UN guiding principles on internal displacement. In our case also, the vast majority of IDPs and refugees are settled in urban areas in the capital city of Baku. About 70% are settled in urban areas, and until now the government, the state, has managed to construct more than 100 new contemporary settlements with all infrastructure built in, and relocate 55,000 families or 275,000 IDPs and refugees. But still, there is a big portion of IDPs, about 400,000, who still live in dire, hard conditions. I would like to particularly emphasize the fact that this year, about the growing role of the private sector in improvement of living conditions of IDPs and refugees. This year, a new settlement for 1,000 families of IDPs was constructed purely, exclusively with the funds coming from private sector, not involving any cent from state budget. Azerbaijan also has developed very advanced legislative basis in relation to IDPs and refugees, which is in full conformity with international law, and we stand ready to share our experience with other countries, with other conflict zones which experience the same problem. In concluding remarks, I would like to underline once again that we remain committed to future cooperation with UNHCR, and thank UNHCR for all past and present activities, and hoping that UNHCR will have an even bigger role when IDPs will finally exercise their fundamental right to return, and this process will be done with participation, with concerted efforts of international community. And thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Azerbaijan. I now give the floor to the last but